A pulley is a wheel with a groove in which a rope or chain passes. Now, sometimes the pulley is supported. And when it is supported, like where you're seeing this one, it is supported and it is fixed. So sometimes the pulley is supported. And so when it is supported and fixed, it is called a fixed pulley. But in other times, it is left to move. And therefore, it is called a movable pulley. Let's look at the fixed pulley first. If you look at this pulley, it is the wheel. It is grooved. And in the groove, this rope is passing through that groove. And at some point, at one end of the rope, we shall fix our load, and the other point, we shall fix our effort. So it means that, let's say, if you want to lift something from the ground, you tie it here, and somebody stands right here and pulls it down, and pulls down. And when he's able to pull the effort down here, this thing will be rotating as the load is being taken up. Now, the dynamics here are such that if you're using an effort, if the load you're pulling is 50 newtons, it means you're going to need 50 newtons to pull it up. Likewise, if you're having a load of 100 newtons right here, the effort you need here is 100. So it means as far as the single fixed pulley is concerned, the effort is equal to the load. And if the groove is frictionless and the weight of the rope is negligible, the mechanical advantage of this is one. Now it means that remember we say that mechanical advantage is going to be equal to load over effort. So it means that if the load is 100 newtons, then it means you're going to use an effort of 100 newtons. And so it means this divided by that will give you one as the mechanical advantage. Now this is theoretical. But in practice, this is not so, because much as the load may be 100, the effort you're going to be using here will be a little bit more than 100, because on top of pulling this load up, you're going to require to add extra effort to overcome the forces of friction, because within this groove there are resistive forces that are being caused around because of friction. Even this rope could be having some weight, so you need more effort to overcome it. So it means that if the load is 100 newtons, you might find that you require to use a little bit more effort, and that will make their mechanical advantage less than one. So in simple terms, in practice, the mechanical advantage won't be one, but theoretically speaking, that is when you assume that there are no frictional forces in this groove, when the effort is exactly equal to the load, then the mechanical advantage of a single fixed pulley will always be one. Now, where is this applied in real life? Now, in real life, we use a single fixed pulley in raising flags. Even when during building construction, to raise certain materials in a construction site, sometimes they use a single fixed pulley. Then also raising soil from a pit. So let's go on and look at the single movable pulley. In the single fixed pulley, the pulley was fixed. But with movable, this pulley, it is not fixed anywhere. It is movable. It means that the rope that is passing by, this is the rope that is fixed. But this pulley is movable. It means that this effort, it can be, when you pull it up, then this pulley comes up. Now, this pulley has got the load on it. So as you pull up, the load keeps coming also. Now, if you look at this closely, you realize that this load, as it is acting downwards, these two ropes are supporting this pulley. And so they are experiencing tension moving up. The load is being supported by these two ropes. And the tension in each rope is equal to the effort being applied. That is why we are saying that this load is going to be equal to this is load moving in that direction, which is L, is going to be equal to twice effort, because there are two ropes supporting this going upwards. So load is equal to 2E. So it follows therefore that the mechanical advantage is going to be equal to load over effort, and the load is 2E. Divide that by the effort E, and you find that the mechanical advantage is 2. Now, so the mechanical advantage of a single movable pulley is 2, And the velocity ratio of the single movable pulley is 2. And why is that so? Because the effort moves twice the distance moved by the load. That's why the velocity ratio of a single movable pulley is 2. A single movable pulley has an efficiency of 85%. So the efficiency is 85%. What load can it raise? So we are looking for the load. What load can it raise? Can be raised by an effort of 40 newtons. The effort is 40 newtons. We know that the efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage over velocity ratio times 100%. Now, what is mechanical advantage? We know that mechanical advantage is load over effort. Now, load, we do not have the load, so it's going to be L over the effort, which is 40. So, mechanical advantage here is going to be load, which we shall remain as L because it's what we are looking for. Divide that by effort, which is 40. So, L over 40, then divide that by velocity ratio. Now, we know that the velocity ratio of a single movable pulley is 2 by default because the effort moves twice the distance moved by the load for a single movable pulley. So it's going to be divide that by velocity ratio, which is 2, multiply that by 100%, is going to be equal to 85. So in this, we make L the subject of the formula and we're able to get the load they are talking about here. So this simply means that our value of L is going to be... Now this brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for tuning in. Up next, we'll look at the block and tackle pulley system. Please remember to subscribe and share this video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Ranga Kuramia.